They drew first blood, not me. Let's go do this. Trooper, time to make the donuts, but not really donuts though, the video, you know what I'm saying? But Dunkin' Donut, no?
Oh man! I just realized I'm starving. Where are we gonna play poker tonight? Operation Uptick is in full effect. Starting on Thursday at 7:07 p.m. I'm hungry. I need food. And coffee. Just so everyone's clear, Operation Uptick is based on a lot of short-term variance. So, clearly, you know, whatever could happen. I mean, like, I could move to 2-5 and I could get busted back down to 1-2 in the first day, or I could make my way halfway to 5-10 in one day. I mean, anything can happen. It's all short term, but I'm gonna manage the risk by doing it the way we're doing it, and we're gonna try to run, you know, this 2K up into like a much bigger number. You know, the World Series of Poker is right around the corner. I don't really know what my plans are yet for that. I don't know if I wanna, I can do anything I want this year because I'm not a Caesars employee. Thank goodness for that. Good luck us, good luck me, good luck making progress tonight, and I don't know, making my way to 3,000. Let's do it.
Alright, so everyone's panties seem to be in a wad over the weight loss challenge with Poker Crowd. I'm not really sure why. I haven't seen his video, but it went up today. I don't know what he said or what went on in his video. I was late getting there. There's a very good reason why I was late. I did everything I could to get there on time. I texted him as I was leaving my apartment and said that I would be 20 minutes late, and it took me longer than 20 minutes to get to downtown. I'm gonna probably watch Poker Kraut's video right now because I have no idea what he said or what has everyone's panties tied in a complete knot. But I can tell you this, the punishment for the weight loss challenge for the loser was not to happen on Saturday. It wasn't supposed to happen then. There's a lot of preparation that needs to go into what the punishment was, and neither of us have anything ready for any of that. So that was something that was gonna happen later anyway. So I just watched the vlog, Poker Kraut's vlog, about the weight loss challenge or whatever, and you know, all I can tell you is I didn't intentionally disrespect Poker Kraut or the challenge or anything else. I will just say this, I think it's unfair for someone to say that I was being disrespectful when they don't even know the reason why I was late. I understand Kevin being disappointed that I was late. First of all, I didn't know he had other people with him, had no idea. I did not know that. I thought that he was alone and that we were meeting and that we were gonna go have lunch after. That was the discussion that we had the day before, well, about having lunch after. So I had no idea that he was there with other people, and I understand him not wanting to hang around with other people, but I don't know. You know, the truth of the matter is that this thing bothers me. It bothers me what Poker Kraut said in the video. Basically what this all comes down to is intention. And it was never my intention to be late. Something was going on that morning that put me way behind. I did everything I could to get there. I text Poker Crowd that I was late. People are saying that I intentionally disrespected Poker Crowd and that I disrespected the bet. I haven't disrespected anything. The fact that I was late was not an act of disrespect. I didn't blow anything off and I didn't intentionally disrespect anybody. I was late. I text Poker Crowd that I was late. I had a text conversation with Poker Crowd the day before, confirming that I would be there. I joked about saying, would it be funny if I didn't show up? And I was actually gonna try to like script something where we made it look like I didn't show up and then he stumbled in and found me, you know, face down in a box of donuts or something. I thought that would be funny. In fact, I still had intentions of suggesting that when we got there. Operation Uptick is over. I did win tonight. I started out down 200. I had King Jack of Hearts on a King 5, 3, 10, 2 heart turn. He had a set of fives and I missed the flush on the river. So we got all in on the turn. Anyway, started out down 200. Then I come back to win this much. $20, that's right. In the game for 500, out for 520. Hey, all we gotta do is do that 49 more times and we'll be up to the 3000 mark. So I was texting with Poker Crowd earlier and I think that he was pissed off when I was late because of something that had happened the day before. On Friday, St. Patrick's Day, the day before the weigh-in, Poker Crowd texts me and he was like, don't forget about noon tomorrow. And I was like, you know, we were talking about eating or whatever. And I made a joke. I was like, would it be funny for the vlog if I didn't show up? I was just kidding with him. And he was like, no, or whatever. And I was like, I know. I'm only joking. I'll be there. So when the day came and I was late, he told me tonight that he thought that I was trying to pull one on him or whatever and that I wasn't showing up. It's clear that I showed up. I have evidence that I showed up. I showed up on camera in the vlog and I text him that I'm there. You know what I mean? So I think that he was a little more pissed off than he would have been had he understood the circumstances. But hey, whatever it is. I mean, you know, for anybody who makes snap judgments about why I was late and whether or not I showed up at all, and especially the few dumbasses that went over to his vlog and said that they're no longer a fan of me because I was late or whatever, you don't know what you're talking about and I don't need you anyway. But just to be clear and to reiterate, the punishment for the bet was not to take place on the 18th. The punishment of the bet was actually going to be, I'm just going to tell you guys a little bit about it right now because I'm not going to tell you exactly what it is because it's supposed to be a surprise. But the punishment for the bet, the day that Poker Crowd and I agreed on the weight loss challenge and we went to eat pizza at Evil Pie or whatever, we discussed a lot of options for how the challenge would work. And we basically both got rather excited about the prospect of what the punishment would be. The whole idea of the punishment was for it to be pretty much a ridiculous thing. And it was supposed to be a separate video. The loser was gonna have to do this thing and we were gonna make a very, very special video out of it. The kind of video that might potentially go viral. That was the whole idea. So, to be honest with you, losing the bet wasn't really something that I would hate so much. It has nothing to do with losing the bet. If I lose the bet and then make a fantastic viral video, then everybody wins. I win and Poker Crowd wins. But, you know, I said in my vlog, I lost the bet. I showed up, I was late. It was an extremely stressful morning, and that's it. I actually do feel a little bad for not giving Poker Crowd a challenge. He wanted a weight loss challenge, and if I was a competing card, then he didn't really get much of a challenge. Something that he really wanted to do, and I turned down the idea several times. And when we were down there for the initial weigh-in, I got excited about the prospect because of the viral video idea as the punishment. Before I start editing yesterday's vlog, let's take a little update of Operation Uptick here. I reorganized the board a bit here. Mission one, the goal is to get to 3,000. Our starting is 2,000. Yesterday, 323, Caesar's Palace, plus 20. Total roll, 2020. This is my new thing, right? So eggs on top of brown rice. But just to show you that it wasn't a complaint the other day, look at this. Put some of that Taco Bell sauce on there. 55 packets. Made my way down to Bally's for the second night of Operation Uptick. Five games here at Bally's. They look decent, just at a glance. Word around the campfire is the games have been pretty good here the last couple nights. Well, look at this, two doors, and up until the last day or two, there were two doors right here also. Now it's just glass. Seems kind of weird. By the time I heard about this, it was way too late. Apparently there was a robbery and a shooting at the Rolex store across the street at Bellagio. It was about 45 minutes ago when this shit happened, but you can see there's a bunch of lights down there. Do I want to go down there? There's probably nothing to see right now. With it being 40 minutes ago, there's probably no reason to walk down there. I'm kind of glad I didn't learn that that happened a lot earlier, because if I had, I might have come out here and tried to vlog some shit. End up getting popped. Molly likes to listen to the police scanner at night. She's probably asleep, because if she had heard something about it, she probably would have messaged me. We may have missed the gunplay, but we did win at poker. Guess what? Night number two, Operation Uptick, plus 341, which is gonna put us plus 361 for Operation Uptick, meaning we have 2361. Hey, 639 to go to mission two. Yo, it's 2:13 in the morning. I'm gonna head home. Remember, if you like my videos, please click the thumbs up button. Why am I so dark? I think the camera's actually gonna die. There it goes. If you like my videos, click the thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.